everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop here, bringing you a style of kit I've never shown on my channel before. And don't get worried, everyone. Don't get your panties all in a wad. This isn't going to turn into a model railroading channel. But this is HBI Guys Model Workshop, and I don't say any specific one type of model. If you've ever talked to me on Facebook or in any other conversation, you know that I like to build everything. I like to build plastic car models, plastic train models, plastic boat models, wood ship models. I like radio control cars, full-size RC cars. I like small RC cars. I like RC airplanes, the micro lights, the large-scale airplanes, the turbine airplanes. I like boats of all types, model boats that just sit on a shelf, model sailboats that you can actually sail, model race boats, model jet boats. I have model hovercrafts that actually work. So, you know, bear with me. If you don't like the review, stop watching now. But I think if you open up your perspective a little bit, look at different types of models and see what out there that is neat and interesting and different, you could actually spice up your shelf space with some cool things. The other thing is, if you know, especially with model railroad building, if you get a kit, a model railroad set, and you've built some really cool houses, you can actually add those to the set for them. They can build them with you. And model railroad buildings, if you get the right brand name, aren't as expensive as you would think. Some of the stuff in the model railroad genre is insanely expensive. Locomotives, when I was a kid, were like $15, and now they're $300 with light, sound, and, you know, computer control. But a lot of these models, like this model here from Model Power Brand, are still in the sub $20 range all day long, and they have hundreds of different models available. And that's what I picked this model up for here, was about $19 and change from my favorite online retailer. This is the Model Power Haunted House. This is an HO scale, which would make it 1/87th. And this would be considered, if this was a plastic model for cars or boats, this would be a skill level 2 because it does require glue and paint. So let's take a look at everything that's in the box for the Model Power Haunted House. Right here is the manual, and a lot of you are going to recognize this as just looking like a regular manual with a parts list from any other glue-together kit, and that's all it is, except you're building a house instead of a vehicle. Open that up. That's your standard directions. It's all exploded views, step by step by step by step. If you ever built a regular plastic model, you can build a railroad model for display. And like I said, you don't have to have a model railroad. These are small enough that they'll look excellent on a shelf with a lot of detail. And something cool like a haunted house has broad appeal to everybody. And you could take a look here. They even include the sidewalk and the fence. And they have all the different ways to assemble it. The only thing different than assembling a car model is, to get all the edges straight and stuff, you're going to want to make sure that you take your time and use a small square. I have some on the workbench here, but they're a little hard to get to. Let me see if I can get one without crashing tools to the ground while you guys are looking at the manual there. But any inexpensive square like this will work just fine. You know, that sits there and you can square up the walls to each other and to the base. You know, you're talking, you know, and you can just use clear plastic ones, like for truing the tails on a model airplane as well. They cost a couple bucks, excuse me, without any issue whatsoever. So just pick one of those up if you're going to build these. You can do it by hand if you use CA glue and you hold them at a right angle and you dry them up quickly, then you won't have any worries as well. Otherwise, it's a straightforward assembly. There's no real tips and tricks that I would have to tell you about that you wouldn't know. So let's look at all the plastic that's in the box. First, we'll look at some of the detail parts for the model. And those look kind of small, but they're not bad at all. They're just a little bit smaller than 72nd scale, so if you built one of those vehicles, you're not going to have any problems with this. You can see how nicely the plastic is done on these. These are your windows for all different areas of the house, your cool-looking doors. If you like to work on houses, I think you'd like assembling these kits. I'm just saying, you know, step out of your normal. Pick something up that's different, especially if you're in a slump with something. Throw something like this together for fun. Nice looking windows on there, and there are a lot of them. There's about 30 of them on there. And then if you have 30 or more windows, you're going to need 60 or so more shutters. And you can look at the great detail molded in there. Very nicely done. No issues. Not a lot of problems with the molds. And the reason this one has so many shutters is because it's a haunted house and you want to make the shutters look all cattywampus, like the house is closed off. You can use some of them. You don't have to use all of them. You know, just like building a car model, you don't have to use every single part in the box to get what you want. There's also some cool accessories included in this kit that you'd have to buy extra from other kits. This is this cool fence that goes all the way around the property. Has that awesome looking gate. Gives it a very Addams Family Munster-ish look to it. And if you're still not convinced that you can build buildings and be a plastic modeler and not a model train modeler, Mobius makes HO scale Munster's House, Mel's Drive-In from American Graffiti, and all that. So if it's cool enough for the Mobius modelers, of which I like, then it's cool enough for all of us to build. You can see some of the stuff plagues plastic models just like it does with a plastic railroad model, just like it does with a car model. They'll have ejector pin marks and some screw-ups on the molds. This is your roof with the cool molded in shingles, and you can see a little bit of schmaltz there, but it's a beat-up haunted house, so it's not going to make much of a difference whatsoever on there. They've got this pre-molded out for the dormers, so you can build the dormers right on it, and then build the dormer roofs. You can build the porch roof. And you see how they molded that in on the porch roof, like the porch is collapsing? It's kind of cool, isn't it? I guess about ready to give way on the crappy old house on the corner that all the kids are afraid of. So we got the fence in there, we've got the roof in there. Here's some more smaller detail parts on some more plastic trees, and these boxes come full. This is your front porch, your deck. You can beat that up, break some holes in it, you know, cut along the lines and snap some holes in it for boards that have given way. You've got that beautiful chimney. Well molded. Lots of weathering and detail on these. You've got the front lattice in the porch, and it's angled like that because the house is kind of leaning to one side a little bit. You know, just like Monster House, the house is kind of cattywampus. Beautiful detail, even all the way down to the poles that hold the porch up. Just phenomenal. Porch steps on there. Even a rock foundation, just like an old house would have. This is a detailer's dream. Same as a good car model. And these don't cost any more than a good car model. Here's the main walls of the house in this tree. You can take a look there. Clapboard siding. Bump outs for everything. All kinds of windows like they would have had in a real one. There's your fronts for your dormers there. There and there. And your back and your side doors. So you could even do, you know, backyard, back porch detail. You can see how it's going to sit at an angle, like it's sinking into its foundation. All nicely done. Lots of crisp detail. For the price and all the plastic you get, not bad at all. Like I said, if you don't like railroad models, that's fine. No one's going to ever make you build one. Some of the other things included in this kit that they don't include in a lot of other kits is an entire base. And I think it's because they want it to be the haunted house, so, you know, you build it a certain way. But they include a sheet of clear acetate, and that's for your windows. So you can put it in some, you can put it in halfway to make it look like it's open. You can cut it out, you can put a seam in it so it looks like it's cracked. That's nice to have in there. They include some grass, and you would cut the grass to fit on this nice base. You can see they've got sidewalk squares. And you would build your house, and you would find out the footprint of your house on the base and see how much room that's going to take up front and side. And then you decide how much yard you want around the house, and then you would cut that to fit the base, and then you would put the fence on, and the rest would be your sidewalk border. And you can detail the sidewalk as you wish, as if it's broken or beat up. You can put some grass in the cracks. You can bust out little sections of the concrete and put, you know, a fake blacktop filler in there. You could cut a seam and lift it. You could bend it up so that it looked like a raised piece of sidewalk, the kind that you'd see when you were a kid and jump off of it, you know, for the next half an hour with your BMX bike. So these kits are a lot of fun. I used to be big into model railroading. I just don't have the room for it in this house here. So when I was a kid, I moved out of my parents' house. I really haven't built another model railroad since then. I had a huge one back in my parents' house, which is still sitting there. And recently I just decided to start putzing around with some of these other plastic models and see what else was out there, and thought you guys might like to take a look. So, you know, on the scale of 1 to 10, like I like to do with these models, this would definitely be an 8 or a 9 because of the the style of it, all the accessories you get with it, and the low price of less than $20. And it could easily be built in a weekend and then painted and detailed from there to your heart's content. So if you're looking for something fun, a little bit of a slump buster, take a look at Railroad Models. You might be surprised what you can find. Thanks for watching.